A study by researchers at Purdue University suggests that some high school football players suffer undiagnosed changes in brain function and as a result continue to play when they should be sidelined. This research is important to athletes everywhere. I'm here with Eric Numan, and he's a co-leader of the research that's going on here at Purdue University and at the Lafayette High School. So can you explain us what the research project you're working on?
Sure, sure. We started out looking at players that had concussions and putting sensors in their helmets, performing neurocognitive tests, looking at fMRI images of their brains, and trying to put all that data together to understand why they get concussions. And what we thought we would do is get some players that didn't receive concussions but took similar hits and then study them as well. And what we found was that about half the kids that we thought were controls were actually showing signs of neurophysiological damage.
Originally, we set out to try to find how different kinds of hits related to different levels of impairment or the risk of concussion, but the most interesting thing that we found, we didn't expect to find whatsoever. We have found a group that exhibits significant impairment at the level of a concussion or worse without having any outward symptoms whatsoever of concussion.
What we hope to gain is a way to improve player safety, to make sure that kids are getting diagnosed and pulled out of the game when they need to be, make sure that we have a way to manage concussions and manage neurotrauma a little bit better.
Impact data from each player were compared with brain imaging scans and cognitive tests performed before, during, and after the season.
So we're collecting three different kinds of data. The first kind of data is computer-based testing. It's a test called the impact test that's used regularly within the NFL and the NCAA and a lot of high schools. It's like a glorified computer game that's measuring their skill level. Then we also use functional MRI, which is a medical imaging method that allows us to see how activation of the brain changes while doing different sorts of tasks. That establishes a baseline that we can compare to then throughout the entire season. Throughout the season, we're collecting biomechanical data using the sensors that are placed in the helmet. That records every single hit that they take at every practice and at every game. Within the season, we also then bring them in for follow-up scans, redoing the computer tests and the fMRI, and then we'll do that again in the postseason. That way, by looking at the progression of their functional imaging and their computer-based tests, we can see how the biomechanical data corresponds to changes within their brain.
The goal of this research is to come to understand, when do these injuries occur? What are the mechanisms we can do to detect those injuries when they are occurring, or what are changes we can make, not to the game, but to the hardware or to the preparation that will allow us to prevent those injuries or at least minimize the risk of being injured in the future. One of the reasons we believe that we've had so much interest in this story is just the fact that so many people play high school football. There are over a million people who play this annually, which means that there's a very large percentage of the population, a large number of people in the population who played this. These are our children who are out there playing football and potentially getting injured, and obviously we don't want something bad to happen to them. So we're very interested in understanding how do we prevent that in the future.
This has been a really exciting project. It's been a fun project. It's research that is not typical either engineering or medical research, but something that certainly is exciting to do at Purdue. It's exciting with our teams, and we're just having a ball with it.
Purdue's cross-disciplinary research team is working to make athletes everywhere more aware and cautious of some of the perils in sports today. I'm Allison Douglas for Boiler Bytes.